Welcome, everyone, to the Kia Knicks postgame show. Tonight, the Knicks in Philadelphia, and they go down 99-96. Another close loss to one of the elite teams in the Eastern Conference. Julius Randle, 19 points, 15 rebounds, 8 assists. Seth Curry, 20 points. This three put the Sixers up 90-89. The Knicks had been up by 9 after 3 quarters. Tobias Harris had 30. The pride of Long Island puts the Sixers up by 4, and they win 99-96. Back in our Delta MSG studios, Bill Pito along with Wally Szczerbiak. Alan Hahn joins us from his home studio. So, guys, again, Knicks hang in there. Very much in the game, Wally, against the top team from the Eastern Conference. And for the second straight game, they have the ball in the final seconds, down 3. For the second straight game, they come away with a loss.
Yeah, they just struggled down the stretch without a true floor general and a true point guard. And this is why I think Derrick Rose was brought in for closing time and to run pick and roll and to make plays down the stretch of a game and give put the ball in the hands of a veteran who's been there, done that, and won basketball games in his career. And, you know, Julius Randle was great. I thought he looked a little fatigued. I thought the fall took a lot out of him. He didn't seem to really have the lift that he had before that. He's been playing a ton of minutes. RJ Barrett was great, but you know, down the stretch, they just couldn't get those easy baskets, couldn't get a fluid offense into a rhythm where they knew where the shots were coming. Everything just seemed so frantic and rushed. And as a result, Tobias Harris just calmly posted up and made 2 nice moves that really sealed this game.
The biggest difference, right, Wally, like you're talking about, is on one end, Tobias Harris finishing on you know, his shots. The Knicks were getting shots they wanted even down the stretch. RJ Barrett had 2 chances. There was also an open shot by Alec Burks. They had open looks, good looks, just didn't knock them down. And that's why, you know, you go 17-7 run. So we can look at all the stuff that happened late, but I'm looking at stuff that happened to me early in the fourth quarter when the Knicks came into the quarter with a 9-point lead and Tom Thibodeau wanted to steal some minutes, and he puts in Obi Toppin and he puts in Frank Ntilikina. He's got a thin roster, as we know. They're missing a couple of key pieces. But still, you've got to get something out of your bench. And that bench just gave the game away, in my opinion. I mean, you had Korkmaz come in, you had Thybulle come in, and they turned the game around for the Sixers. Thybulle playing great defense, Korkmaz making plays, making shots, and all of a sudden, a 9-point game that you felt like if you can maintain that and then you can just hold there, you knew once you had Ben Simmons resting, you had Tobias Harris resting, so once they got back in the game, they were ready to take this game over. So to me, the game, yes, plays late might have cost you the game, but I feel like the game turned early fourth quarter when a couple of players came in off the bench and could not get the job done.
Now, Frank Ntilikina had some flashes, but this is his 3rd straight game not scoring a single point.
Yeah, so that was a big problem.
You know, when you don't have Rose and you don't have Payton and you have Emmanuel Quickley, doesn't seem like he's 100%. You had to get something out of Frank because Alec Burks had to play a lot of the time at the point.
No, he did. And you can just see Tom Thibodeau, he just needs guys that are experienced out there and that he can trust to produce. And, you know, he's trying to steal minutes, like Alan said. I couldn't agree with him more. I just thought, you know, the Knicks worked so hard to build that 9-point lead, and then you go to your bench with Obi Toppin and Frank Ntilikina, and it's just scary when they're out there. It really is. And then, you know, down the stretch, you got a close game. And Seth Curry was unbelievable with these threes he was drilling. He was drilling 30-footers the whole second half. That three makes it a 1-point game, 90-89. And there's Tobias Harris. That's just way too easy. Blows around Reggie Bullock, gets that 2. And then he uses his size over Reggie Bullock. The next possession gets an easy turnaround. So now they have a 4-point lead. That was a nice play. You know, Barrett gets the dunk, but again, it was a frantic play. This was the big miss, down 2, just short arm the shot a little bit by RJ Barrett, and then the rebound. And then here's the last play of the game. Emmanuel Quickley, you know, that's a decent shot, and I understand. You got to try to get a shot up. Randle, huge rebound. Reggie Bullock had his heel on the baseline. They did not have a timeout, so they could not challenge that play. That's why they couldn't challenge, because they didn't have a timeout left. And that was just the game. And the momentum shifted. And you know, in a close game, Philly's experienced. They have guys that have been there. They have guys that know how to win. And the Knicks just came up short. But they are thin with their roster because they can't trust some of those guys that they put in the game off the bench right now. They just can't. And they need to figure out how to get production out of someone. Maybe a lineup change is in order.
A lineup change. who's going to play? That's the problem. There's not a lot of guys available. Wally, like, you know, you and I are on the same page with this. When we saw it, we saw.
Kevin
But we
Knox.
Also have to understand that
Kevin
this
Knox?
Is what you have to live through. Another young player.
So what?
That has
I mean,
to
Kevin
earn
Knox
trust.
Shot 40% at the beginning of the season. All of a sudden, he became situational. I mean, look at what, right? I mean.
Well, no. And that's what, but okay, but that's what I said is who do you have? See, understand. But what I was adding to this was, you've got to understand that this is an incomplete roster. You knew this coming into the season. This is an overachieving team. We all acknowledge that. This is a well-coached, overachieving team. And so you're going to have nights like this where you go up again. Think about this. This is back-to-back nights. Mike Breen said it, and he's right. On a back-to-back, the Knicks went toe-to-toe with the number one and number two teams in the East. Now, sure, both teams are missing key players. No Kevin Durant, no Joel Embiid. But still, this is a young team, mainly, that went toe-to-toe, but you knew they just didn't have enough to make the plays down the stretch, and that's what's going to happen. This is not a complete roster. This is not a championship roster. This is still a growing, learning roster, and these are the growing pains. These are the games that are frustrating because you know you just still don't have enough. But, you know, I still say that you had an opportunity to steal this game, to win this game. They had shots late. R.J. Barrett, just you showed the one. There was another one, too, where he just misses a good look in the paint. Key plays like that change the game. But your bench has to do more in the early fourth quarter to keep that lead.
Now, the whole dynamic.
Whoa. What happened to this guy over the All-Star break? I mean, get him a remote. Get him a coffee mug. Are you kidding me? The Knicks should have won this game. They had a 9-point lead in the fourth quarter. No Joel Embiid. You got Danny Green throwing up bricks, shooting 1-for-10. And you can't. Okay, you did break another one. Good. You better. I mean, you look way too happy over there, big guy. I mean, this is a game the Knicks needed. They could have had this one. They played so hard. They played so well. And just down the stretch of the game, you know, it just frustrates me when you have guys out there that just, it is an honor to be an NBA player and get NBA minutes. And when you get on the floor and you're a winning team, you have to take advantage of those minutes. You have to produce for your team. And it just drives me crazy when guys are out there and they're not playing up to their, producing for
but
their
But, Wally,
spot.
This is how you learn. Wally, isn't this, and this is why I don't, like, we used to talk about this all the time. You'd have a young team. Well, he's got to play 38 minutes a night, and he's got to deal with it. No, I think you learn about players with moments like this. Can I trust you? Okay, we've got a 9-point lead. I'm going to put you in the game, and yeah, I've got to see if I can trust you. And the more times you see somebody in those moments, instead of down 35 and he's playing, you know, the second half and all of a sudden scoring because there's no real pressure. No, I need to see you in the crucible to really get to know what I've got. And you need to also experience that baptism by fire to understand that the next time you're in this situation, if you're Obi Toppin, if you're Frank Ntilikina, or maybe even Kevin Knox, that you know next time around, look at the clock, time, score, situation. All right, I got to hold here. The worst I got to do is come out even. So when my starters get back in the game, we at least still maintain the lead that they worked hard for. That's all stuff that's learning experience. That's your 10,000 hours. It's not going to happen overnight when you have a young roster like this.
Reality, guys, if Derrick Rose is healthy, if Elfrid Payton is healthy, we're not having this conversation.
It makes a big difference. It makes the game so much easier for Julius Randle. And I'm telling you, Randle is putting his body on the line because he doesn't have other guys that can produce and help him out. And I've seen it before. He's playing so many minutes. He's attacking the basket. It's a close game. You're going to put your body on the line. You're going to do everything to try to help your team win. He needs some help out there, and hopefully the Knicks guys can get healthy because, right now he's being asked to do a lot.
Story of the game, really.
It was also the trade deadline.
Right.
That's coming up, too.
March
Keep 25th, that in mind.
March 25th. Now,
that's right.
The key thing we're talking about, the stretch. Overall, the Knicks only scored 14 points in the fourth quarter.
Yeah.
So, all right, up to the minute, up to the second standings in the East, the Sixers with the win. Now game in front of the Nets. Knicks now in eighth. It's so close. Got to be in the top 10 to have a chance at a play-in game. 7 through 10 this year. And right now the Knicks have a game and a half lead over the Pacers, who were not playing well at all. Bulls against OKC tonight. So, you know, when you look at this on a night-by-night basis, unfortunately, if you lose three or four in a row, the whole complexion can change.
Well, that's what we looked at the schedule. It's a really tough schedule coming down the stretch for the Knicks. So you have to take advantage when you're playing well without Joel Embiid in the lineup. And, you know, the Knicks are going to see the Sixers coming up in a few days without Joel Embiid in the lineup. So they got to get that win. They got to return the favor. They got to get some payback. They got to get healthy. They got to get right, because there's not much margin of error in these standings. And that's why Allen better have more mugs and more remotes to break, because you can't be affording to lose these games when you worked so hard in the first three quarters to build yourself a 9-point lead. And then the bench, like you said, Allen, it's a great point, started off the fourth quarter and completely gave the momentum away. And then it's tough for the starters to come back, change the momentum. You're on the road. You don't have a point guard. It's not easy. So you got to go back to the drawing board and not let these type of games slip away.
Want to update, you saw the standings. The Bulls won, so
yeah,
that was reflected there in the standings. And just for the record, I'm the calm one of the three out here tonight, which is not normally the case. But hey,
I want NBA players on my basketball.
We are invested in this team. Tom Thibodeau.